now that I got my coffee, let's talk about this guy, the Canon EOS R versus the Canon EOS EOS OR6.
If there's one thing I know about doing videography is nothing ever goes as planned. As you can tell, it's obviously not the same day. Still got my coffee though, but you know, it's not the same day. So we're just gonna roll with this. I've been trying to film this video for a while now. It just seems like something keeps happening and we're just gonna have to make it happen. So right now I'm filming on the Canon, we're just gonna call it the R6 because I can't say EOS R, EOS and all that. So just the R6 and the R, that's what we're gonna refer to these as. But so what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a real world test. You guys know I don't get into all the technical stuff and all that. And there's plenty of things on YouTube for that. So this is all about real world results and coffee. But anyways, we're gonna film some shots with both cameras and I'm gonna see if you guys can tell which one was which. Now I'm gonna film both of these in 1080p because the 4K in the R is cropped. So I'm just gonna kind of throw that out the window and we're just gonna focus on the 1080p. Woo, there's some thunder. You guys see that? Gah! There's a storm moving in. So we'll try to get this done without getting struck by lightning. Anyways, so let's check it out. Here's some footage from the cameras and let me know if you guys can tell which is which. Also, I will do 720p and 120 for the R just because it doesn't have it in 1080. So, all right, let's do it. But one thing I can tell you that I noticed right away is the low light capabilities of the R is not near as good as on the R6. I'm actually vlogging right now on the R. I'm actually shooting, if I haven't mentioned it, the 16mm to 35mm f2.8 L-series. But I can really tell you there's a big difference in low light capabilities. So let's switch over to the R6 and let you guys see kind of what the difference is. The lighting keeps changing. It's kind of a cloudy day and I haven't got struck by lightning yet, so that's good. So let's switch and see what it looks like. So just a side note, I have to say I absolutely love Fayetteville, Arkansas. This place is amazing. Such a cool place to go shoot. Anyways, has nothing to do with the review, just kind of want to throw that out there. First of all, before I get into my final thoughts on this camera, I want to tell each and every one of you, thank you for subscribing to this community, for interacting with me, for letting me know your thoughts, and for watching these videos. It means a whole lot to me. I put a lot of effort into these to give you guys great content and real world thoughts, and just means so much to me that you guys take the time out of your busy schedule to watch these. So if you have any more thoughts or something else you'd like to see, drop them in the comments below. Let me know. I love interacting with you guys. But so here's my final thoughts on the EOS R6 and the R. I think the R is a great camera. It holds its own. It is no slouch for its price point. I think that you can grab that for about $1,200 now. Something around in there, use one, and that's a great price for a full frame camera that shoots great footage. You can even use the 4K, even though it's cropped, the bit rate on this camera is really good. I think it's like 400 megabits per second, so it's really high, and it's really, really good. And I know that a lot of times the 1080p that I shoot with it, if I up-res it to 4K, it's really great because the bit rate, again, is so, so good. So it is no slouch. I've shot a lot of good content on it. The downside of that camera though, for me, the biggest thing is the dynamic range. It's just really not that great. And then the low light, it's just not great in low light. And until I compared these two and did the same shots, I really didn't notice that big of a difference. It does have C-Log and the C-Log is good, but when it comes to low light performance, it's just not that great. So if those two things are important to you, well, actually three things, slow motion in 1080p and great low light performance and all those different things, then I gotta switch arms. This is getting really, really heavy. Sorry guys. Then I would definitely look past the R, especially if you have the money. So let's talk about the R6. To me, for $2,500, this camera is amazing. That's what I'm shooting on right now. For the majority of the vlog, that's what I've shot on. And man, let me tell you, this thing has great, great 1080p. The low light performance out of this thing is really good. No, it's not a Sony. You've heard me say that before, and it's not as good as the Sony. And the dynamic range is not as good either. But man, for the money, if you're invested into Canon glass like I am, you're not gonna find a better option. I've never shot with the R5, but I've heard the 4K in this is better than the 4K in the R5 because it line skips. This doesn't have all eye, but I think it looks really, really, really clean, and it's got a great image. The C-Log is great. I'm hoping for C-Log 3 in an update. I don't know if that's gonna happen, but the price difference though, I mean, the thing of it is like, I think the R6, like we said, is $1,200. This thing is like $2,499 when I bought it. Now it could be different now, but that's a big difference. That's a lot of money. So I think if you're looking at the budget and the money, you can get a lot out of the R. If you know its weaknesses and you work around those, there's nothing wrong with it. So I hope you enjoyed this review. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to subscribe, hit that bell notification, and we will see you guys in the next video. Peace.